Our next bout this evening sees Troy Boy's Joshua Thistleton in the blue, the black shorts with the gold trim, and Jason De St Croix, KO Company, in the red. He's in the all black shorts, and again, matching gloves to corner. Joshua blue gloves, Jason in the red. So Jason leads with the stiff jab, looks for the jab to the body, and then the overhand right, very sharp. Jason holding his hands, Joshua holding his hands very low as Jason came in there, looking to push Jason back. Joshua told to put his jab out, little uppercut there from Jason, who's pushing forward, works the jab to the body this time. Joshua fires that jab back as Jason commands center ring here, just stepping away, look for the big uppercut, but the right hand landed. The crowd responded. Joshua took it well, but he doesn't want to keep taking them. He holds his hands very low as he throws his punches. And Jason, staying disciplined, throws the jab, then the left to the body. And the jab once more. Joshua looks for his own right hand as he pulls out with the jab. He's saying the glove's undone here. The tape over the lace. So Jason taken to the neutral corner. They touch gloves. And Joshua, that left arm was trapped there. And he pulls with that left jab, looking, you know, to throw the right just like that. But he throws it out of range and got caught with the right and left counter. And you can see everything with Joshua is to set up that right hand. But up and down now, the body shots ripping in from Jason now as he steps forward. Joshua took them well. Look for the right uppercut through the channel, then the stiff left. So, solid opening round, you've got to say, for Jason De St Croix. Joshua Thistleton pulling out with the left, looking for the opportunity to throw the big right hand. But overall, it was a controlling round by the red corner. So round two or three, Jason in control of round one there. And he's working behind that stiff jab again, the peekaboo guard there for Joshua, but he needs to get a tighter guard and step in closer to make his own counters more productive here and carry more weight. And he's wide open when he throws. Joshua shakes his head from the shots from Jason. A little bit of game-ology there from him. And he shakes his head again, kidology. But despite shaking his head, he's getting caught. And that's the thing. So, to his credit, he's taken some very solid punches. But he needs to tighten his guard. And when he's coming back on the counter, he needs to be that bit closer to get more power into his shots, to get more weight into them. He's throwing arm punches at the moment, Again, using that peekaboo. But Moore needs to come back.
Stop messing his hair up.
And looks for the left hook of his own when he gets the opportunity. But he's just being outpointed at the moment, Joshua, from Jason's work ethic. He's just stuck to his game plan. Worked behind a very good straight jab. Tight guard. Throwing the right when necessary. And then slips to the body with those left and rights. And Joshua looks to respond, but again, he's just out of range with his own shots. It's been a comfortable second round for the man in the red corner, picking his shots, picking up the points, staying out of trouble. Not trying to do anything too fancy, just making sure that he's taking the bout solidly over these opening two rounds. Well, Fabio there made a decision. As I was saying, it was all right with Joshua saying he wasn't hurt and saying that it wasn't hurting him, but there was nothing really coming back. He had a solid chin, but a good call from Fabio there. There was very little really coming back from Joshua as Jason came in, and he's saving his boxer from further punishment there. Good call, as always, from Fabio. He wasn't hurt, Joshua, but he wasn't making it competitive either. Yes, good call by Fabio.
And a big round of applause for the opponent, Joshua Thistleton, everyone. Well done, Joshua.